Hello and welcome to Access All Areas. Today I'm in Plymouth to take a look at their attractions and find out how accessible they are. Let's go and take a look. Plymouth is a city on the south coast of Devon, whose rich history extends back to the Bronze Age. To kick off my visit, I've come to Plymouth City Museum and Art Gallery to find some more about the city's fascinating past. This is a great place to visit, offering free admission to 9 permanent galleries, 2 exhibition galleries, and hundreds of events and activities throughout the year. You can learn about life and death in ancient Egypt and see fascinating objects from Asia, Africa, Oceania, and Europe. And of course, learn about the rich history of Plymouth itself. You can also see a large collection of decorative art and Plymouth porcelain. So, what about the accessibility? For those with mobility issues, level access to the ground floor is available for wheelchair users from the rear of the main building. Wheelchairs can be borrowed free of charge. There is lift access to the upper floor galleries and accessible toilets on the ground floor. For people with a hearing impairment, a fixed audio loop is available at the welcome desk. Portable loops are also available for the shop and cafe and in the actual gallery during lunchtime talks. To see a different view of Plymouth, take a 1-hour harbour cruise, leaving from the landing stage next to the Mayflower steps. In 1620, the Pilgrim Fathers left Plymouth for the New World from this famous spot, known as the Mayflower Steps after the ship they sailed in.
We're going to come onto an open slipway on the right bank.
Your skipper will provide an informative commentary as you sail across the Plymouth Sound, passing Plymouth Hoe, the famous Drake's Island, and heading for the River Tamar, where mighty warships and nuclear submarines await. This boat, the Spirit of Plymouth, has 4 wheelchair accessibility on the lower deck and saloon, and includes accessible toilets too. For those with a hearing impairment, a written commentary can be provided, and guide dogs are welcome for people with a visual impairment. Plymouth is also home to the UK's largest aquarium. Let's go take a look. Come on a journey across the world's oceans, from the shores of Plymouth to the coral reefs of the tropics, and discover amazing facts along the way. Did you know that jellyfish have existed for over 650 million years? They have over 70 sharks here, from the small catfish to the large sandtail. Good job on the other side of this glass. The aquarium staff also deliver an action-packed talk schedule, including a not-to-be-missed interactive dive show. But how accessible is the aquarium? The majority of the building is serviced by walkways, with ramps or lifts supplied where there are stairs. A limited number of wheelchairs are available on site free of charge. There are also accessible toilet facilities. Carers and personal assistants are admitted free of charge, plus guide dogs and listening dogs are welcome. There are also a limited number of accessible parking bays, which are available on a first-come, first-served basis to those displaying a valid blue badge. There are plenty of other things to see and do in Plymouth. While you're here, why not take a tour of the famous gin distillery? The distillery offers lifts, stair lifts, and accessible toilets. It's the oldest working distillery in England and has a variety of tours so you can learn all about its history and heritage. And if you are staying for the evening, why not catch a show at the Theatre Royal? The theatre has accessible toilets on all 4 floors, ramps and a lift on the ground floor, and all counters have a lower section for wheelchair users. They also have audio described performances and provide an additional seat free of charge for patrons who need to be accompanied. Well, that brings me to the end of my time in Plymouth. It's a beautiful city with great accessibility features. So what are you waiting for? See you next time on Access All Areas.